As we kindle this flame, we honor and remember those who have passed into the mystery. Their brightness lives on in our vision. Their courage lives on in our commitments. And their love continues to bless the world through us. And the opening words for today: we know for certain that we never lose the people we love, even to death. They continue to participate in every act, thought, and decision we make. Their love leaves an indelible imprint in our memories, and we find comfort in knowing that our lives have been enriched by having shared their love.
In the singing of our first hymn, number 103 in your hymnal, the words will appear on the screen. For all the saints. Have the reading. They are with us, still.
In the struggles we choose for ourselves, in the ways we move forward in our lives and bring our world forward with us, it is right to remember the names of those who gave us strength in this choice of living. It is right to name the power of hard lives well lived. We share a history with those lives. We belong to the same motion. They too were strengthened by what had gone before. They too were drawn on by the vision of what might come to be. Those who lived before us, who struggled for justice and suffered injustice before us, have not melted into the dust and have not disappeared. They are with us still. The lives they lived hold us steady. Their words remind us and call us back to ourselves. Their courage and love evoke our own. We, the living, carry them with us. We are their voices, their hands, and their hearts. We take them with us, and with them choose the deeper path of living.
Of welcoming and honoring ancestors is an ancient spiritual practice found in many cultures and traditions. So we begin this presentation, a wonderful slide presentation by Ginny, by paying tribute and expressing gratitude to our ancestors. From our histories, our ancestors call to us. We are grateful for their gifts, their lessons, and their challenges, calling us into accountability and responsibility to fulfill their hopes and aspirations for what they dreamed ours to do. We call on and invoke our parents, grandparents, aunts, and uncles, our siblings from across time and place, to be here with us. We call on the early Unitarians and Universalists, lay people and ordained ministers who brought our faith tradition to the United States from Transylvania. We call on the deceased ancestors who helped build, grew, and sustain this fellowship. We call on those who represent citizens of Manitowoc, those who strove to build a beloved community representing diverse cultures and traditions, including the indigenous people of different tribes. We call upon our activist ancestors, those who struggled for justice, freedom, and liberation of all people, who challenge us to honor the fullness of each and every human being. We especially lift up those who battled racism and oppression, which unfortunately for all is still alive today. They ask us to join the ongoing struggle to make this city whole. We call upon and honor the beauty of the earth, that particular part of creation in which this fellowship ministers, beautiful Lake Michigan, the colorful trees and the forests, the sights and the sounds of our animals and vegetation, and all of the geographical features which support our interconnectedness to nature and to the history of the land itself. Please call to mind your own particular ancestors, family roots, spiritual mentors and guides. Each one of us brings into the room our own network of people and places. We welcome this great cloud of witnesses to join us as we celebrate in sight and sound some of them. Thank you. Thank you, Ginny. And now, in memory and honor of all these people, we would like to light a candle for each one of them.
Tony,
and at the conclusion, we will light candles for anybody who has not been included in the slideshow, but who we would like to remember.
We'll start with Toni Morrison, Jean Kennedy Smith, John Lewis, Ruth Bader Ginsburg, Kate and Daniel Hanrahan, Rusty and John Urban, Frank Smozzle and Mamie Schmutzer, Milton and Mary Gay, Bertina Nordby, Arnie Retney, Earl John Theaker, Adelaide Bowes Lenarduzzi, Polly and Art Fishbeck, Dick Kennedy, Valerie Caldwell, Clyde and Barbara Everett, and the deceased members and friends of our very own fellowship, Shirley Gators, Catherine Helgeland, George Edwards, Vince Holschbach, Vicki Mayer, Sean McMonagle, Beth Barfield, and Susan Phillips.
Are there others among you who we would like to remember?
Al Geimer.
Oh. Kathie, yes. Can you hear me? Layla and Hayden asked the candle be lit for their grandma Laura.
One for Michael Estiza, my brother's husband. Michael Estiza.
Nice guy.
Please light a candle for my neighbor when I was growing up on the farm, David Hoey.
Please light a candle for the patients that I lost, Betty and Lillian.
If you could light a candle for Sally Thompson, our veterinarian, Dr. John's wonderful wife and educator at Mishicot.
Could you light a candle for all the people who died from COVID?
Please light a candle for Joanne Anderson.
My grandmother, Millie Broking.
My father, Gene Kimball.
My friend Lib, who introduced me to the UU.
Does it have to be anyone specific?
No.
To those that have died of COVID because people didn't like take in the fact that they were people. Hem. Heh.
Anyone else?
My father's mother, Helena Strauss.
I've got a lot of candles, so.
My mother, Betty Dickert.
Any others?
My good friend,
Kathy Zuki.
My friend, Linda Dvorak.
My cousin, Helen Carollo.
My parents, Fred and Gertrude Best.
For our friends, John and Karen Webster.
My sister, Gwen.
My brother, Tommy Gay, he was the only boy in that family photo in the PowerPoint, the beautiful boy. He died at the age of 20.
I can't remember your name, but your finger for lighting all those candles.
Anyone else?
I would like to just light a candle for all the special pets who in many cases are like our children who have passed away this year as well.
Anyone else? Okay, I'll light one last candle for those many people who remain in our hearts who we have not mentioned today. A lot of beautiful light here. Lighting our ways. Wonderful ancestors who've meant so much to all of us. May their light shine in each and every one of us, as I'm sure you all reflect upon these people that we have mentioned and those who are not mentioned, how important they have been in each and every one of our lives. Okay, hymn number 354, We Laugh, We Cry.
We dance.
life, whom we know best in our own loving and being loved. Hold us as we remember those who have loved and those who have loved us. May our gratitude sparkle in our lives. May our tears lubricate our souls. Help us to know that we are not alone in our grieving. And help us also to come to that peaceful place in which we can take what we learned from those who have gone before us into our lives. Remind us that we too are mortal, and that the only enduring legacy we leave is the love that shines in our lives.